Hi, this is the SP Architect. In this video, I'm going to show you more tools and some tips about that. Here we have more tools that can be used in most designs that you cannot do with native BIM tools. We have several drawing types here, like SketchUp, there is line, rectangle, circle, cube, and revolving. First one, I click the line. On the floor plan, I draw like a sketch, basic lines, and close the shape. If you don't close the shape, it doesn't fill the inside and you can't get the volume. If I click the face, we are going to see several options. First one is extrude. I simply enter a value. Second one is tube tool. It continues to extruding the clicked face. Third one is bulge tool that you can make organic shape like swelling. After click the face, just click the radius point and move the mouse with Z axis. Instead of doing that, you can draw lines on that face. For example, I make a triangle face here. Then I click the face, click the push-pull, we can offset these edges too by this button. Okay. While offsetting the edges, if you press the Ctrl key, a new border appears and old one still same. Afterwards, we can continue to extruding to complete the shape. There is also edge editing tool right here. You can change the position of the selected edge to different axes. Other tool is chamfer tool that you can chamfer or fill edges. You can change the radius here. Ctrl Z, I click the edge again. We can also change the resolution to increase or decrease detail. You can also use the chamfer options. This input radius 25. If you click apply the all edges, the operation will affect all the edges. Okay, the second option to make a morph is rectangle. Other option is rotated rectangle. You can use this on any surface and rotation. The other option under this icon is circular. You can make a half circle and continue to drawing with other tools. I click this pencil and click the endpoint of the circle. Since we closed the shape, ArchiCAD filled the inside. Afterwards, I click the created face and click the push-pull. Click to finish. Let's rotate this shape. Click that corner. Determine the axis and input 90 degrees. Just click the face again, select the circle, input the circle radius, then complete the shape. After that, I click the push-pull, extrude to inside and make a hole. The other creating method is box type. A box is created with one operation. ARCHICAD automatically creates working place on the clicked shapes. Let's jump to last tool, Revolve Morph. To use this tool, first we are going to draw the section, then axis. You can make this in the 3D, but it's a little hard to set up, so I go to Plan View. I click the Morph, draw the shape. I click this one, or maybe this. Afterwards, I draw the revolving axis, then revolution angle, input the dimension, and OK. You can think this as a base. So I'm going to rotate this one to 90 degrees. Let's go to its elevation. You can also work with the elevation or sections. This can be more useful for some stations. Once you complete the shape, you can input the axis like before. I want to show you how to stretch a morph now. You click the morph you want to stretch. Here we have box tool. You click this one and you will see a box surrounded. You can simply click face and corners and stretch the morph. To finalize, click anywhere different from the morph. There is a different editing tool that you will use often, the sub-element selection. If you click this, you can directly select the edges and edit them. You can select left to right or right to left or directly click. For example, I click this edge and move. Like this. Now I'm going to show you solid element operations for morphs. Let's copy this to here and right click this one. Here we have Boolean operation. Click subtract, then click the main morph. Another sample for this one. Let's move this shape inside the main morph. Just push inside a little, right click and subtract, then click the morph. This part I'm going to show you custom modeling to make a morph. Let's make simple line first, then make a second line. Let's go to 3D, rise a little, make lines to sides, here and here. We made this custom shape, join them together with union tool, this one. Now this is one piece. Let's go to design menu, modify morph, click cover with faces, smooth and OK. We have a warning, click OK. To check the problem, click the solidify. We see pink lines and green lines. Green lines show us open parts and we are going to close. As you can see, there is a gap here. I go to sub element selection, click this point and drag the other corner. Let's also control other corner if there was a gap. This seems okay. I go to modify morph, click the cover with faces. Okay. You can make very interesting designs and shapes with this one. Let's copy this. Delete inside. Select sharp edges. Yeah, you can see the difference. You can also change the existing edges. Just think that this was a curtain. This only needs extra curves. The last thing which is I am going to show you is morph tube. This can be very interesting. I'm going to draw here a shape, like a cornice. It must be perpendicular to the face. I make this with perspective view, which is not correct too much. You shall do this on the elevations. Okay, once we have this shape, I click the face we just created and click the tube. Then I click the corners one by one or use the magic wand tool for the magic. As you can see, this is a very interesting tool and can be used in most designs. I also use sub-element selection for moving this one. Okay. This is the morph tool. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and like. Actually, to like is more important for me. Take care. See you at the next one.